Ahí estamos. Ahí estamos. Now that's really intense, but think about it. God would. Entonces, ¿qué dice acá? Now that's really intense, but think about it.
Ahora eso es realmente intenso, pero pensamos acerca.
Piensa no. acerca de eso, ¿verdad? Think about it. Think about
acerca.
It. Hasta acá. God wouldn't be good.
Dios no podría ser bueno.
Ajá. Permíteme.
Get angry at Pharaoh's evil.
If he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil.
Si él no se enojaba.
Uh-huh.
Con la ira del faraón. Con la maldad del faraón.
Con la maldad del faraón. Uh-huh.
If he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it. And no.
And eventually do something about it. And eventually do something about it.
Eventualmente algo hace algo
sobre
eso.
Y
eventualmente hacía algo al respecto, ¿verdad?
Notice that God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decision.
¿Qué dice ahí, mira, pues?
Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decision is expressed by handing and eventually do something about it. And notice that God's anger is expressed.
Dice, and notice that God's anger is expressed.
Y la noticia.
No.
No.
Y noté.
Y dice, y nota. O sea, dice, nos está hablando a nosotros, ¿verdad? Así como yo te digo, mira, yo te digo nada más, sí, ¿verdad? O look, mira. Entonces aquí nos está diciendo anares y nota, to notice, ¿verdad? Y nota
que el enojo de Dios,
que la ira de Dios es expresada. Espérame que como que Milce no puede entrar. ¿Ok? Entonces nota cómo la ira de Dios es expresada.
Expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions.
By handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions.
Teacher, no sé si lo voy a decir bien. Handing es como alcanzarlo o no.
Entregar.
Entregar.
Entregar, porque es como entregar con la mano. Estoy haciendo esto. Tengo algo en la mano y lo entrego. I am handing. ¿Verdad? By handing Pharaoh over the consequences of his own decisions.
¿Entregando al faraón las consecuencias de sus decisiones?
Entregando al faraón.
Uh-huh.
A las consecuencias de sus propias decisiones. O sea, la ira de Dios se expresó simplemente dejando que a Faraón le sucediera lo que él mismo estaba haciendo. O sea, porque al final Faraón murió en medio del mar persiguiendo a los israelitas. ¿Verdad?
Ah, sí, murió en el mar.
Ah, sí, es que él, como después de que Dios abrió el mar, o sea, pasaron los israelitas. Y entonces Faraón, como vio el mar abierto, dijo, yo también puedo. Y se metió para ir a perseguir a los israelitas. Y cuando iba a medio mar, Dios cerró el mar. Entonces se ahogó él y su ejército.
Había pensado yo que se había ahogado su ejército, pero él la había salvado.
Pero es que eso es por la película de la película esa de...
Ajá, de Disney.
Ajá, esa, pero esa película pues no es... O sea, el problema de las películas es que a veces, muchas veces, cambian las historias. ¿Verdad?
Sí, sí.
And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. Like in...
And this is actually...
Actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures.
And this is actually how God God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures.
Y esto es realmente
exactamente como el enojo de Dios
es mostrado.
Mostrado
throughout, a través de las escrituras.
Like in the story of the Israelites.
Like in the story of the Israelites.
Over and over again for hundreds of years.
De los Israelitas.
Over and over again. Over
una
and over again.
Otra vez.
Una y otra vez.
Una y otra vez.
Por cientos, over and over again. Por cientos de años.
Cientos de años.
They betray the God who over and over again for hundreds of years they betray the God who rescued them from slavery.
They betrayed the God who rescued them from slavery.
God who rescued them from slavery.
Over and over again for hundreds of years, una y otra vez por cientos de años, they betrayed the God who rescued them from slavery.
¿Qué es betray?
Traicionar. Ellos traicionaron al Dios quien los rescató a ellos de la esclavitud.
They betray the God who rescued them from slavery. And though he gives them many chances to turn around, they keep...
And though.
Y a pesar, no.
A pesar de eso, he gives them many chances.
Él les dio a ellos muchas oportunidades.
To turn around.
De voltearse o de regresarlo.
Ajá. A pesar de que él les dio muchas oportunidades para que se regresaran o se arrepintieran, ¿verdad?
Giving their allegiance to the gods of other nations.
To the gods of other nations. They keep, ellos siguen dando su lealtad, allegiance. To the gods of other nations.
A los dioses
de otras naciones. Uh-huh.
De otras naciones.
And each time we read that the hot anger of God burned against the Israelites.
And each time we read.
Y cada vez.
We read.
Nosotros leemos that the hot anger of God burned against the Israelites. But notice what always follows. God gave against the Israelites. But notice what always follows.
Pero nota lo que siempre sigue.
Anger of God burned against the Israelites. But notice what always follows. God gave them over into the hands of their enemies.
God gave them over into the hands of their enemies. God gave them over. Dios los entregó. Gave them over into the hands of their enemies.
Israel wanted to serve the gods of other nations, and so God, in his just anger, gives them what they want.
Israel wanted to serve the gods of other nations.
Israel quería servir a los dioses de otras naciones.
And so God, in his just anger, gives them what they want.
So God, in his just anger, gives them what they want.
En su justicia.
Y así que Dios, en su justa, justo
enojo. Y Dios, en su justa ira, gives them what they want.
Les dará lo que ellos quieren.
Les da lo que ellos quieren.
So God, in his just anger, gives them what they want, as those nations circle back and defeat Israel.
Como esas naciones, como que los circulan, ¿verdad? Y los vencen. y vencen a Israel. To defeat es vencer. To defeat.
As those nations circle back and defeat Israel. This is similar to what the Apostle Paul says in his letter to the Romans.
This is similar what the Apostle Paul says in his letter to the Romans.
Esto es similar que el apóstol Pablo dijo
el apóstol en su carta. Pablo dice en su carta a los Romanos.
To what the Apostle Paul says in his letter to the Romans. He says God's anger is being revealed against human evil, and then
God's anger is
la ira de Dios es.
Buenos días, madre, te busca. Un momento, ahorita. God's anger is being revealed against human
evil, and then three times.
La ira de Dios se revela.
And then three times, o sea, la ira de Dios. Madrecita, te buscan. God's anger is being revealed against human evil.
And then three.
¿Qué dice ahí entonces? God's anger is being revealed.
La ira de Dios es revelada.
Against human evil.
Sobre la maldad humana.
Three times he says what that looks
and
like.
And three times he says.
And then three times he says what that looks like.
Tres veces más.
Y
aunque tres veces él dijo que eso.
¿Cómo se mira?
¿Cómo se mira?
Y tres veces ¿cómo? Él dice cómo eso se mira.
Tres veces.
Three times he says what that looks like. God hands people over to their destructive desires and
dice, God hands people over.
Dios le da mano.
Dios los entrega. God entrega. Hands people over. Handing, ¿verdad? Hands. O sea, to hand es entregar, ¿verdad? Hands people over to their destructive desires.
Destrucción.
A sus deseos destructivos. Destructive desires. ¿Verdad?
Yes.
Que es desires. Destructive.
Decisión.
Deseos destructivos y decisiones.
Deseos y decisiones. Deseos y decisiones destructivos.
Dice deseos destructivos y decisiones.
Decisions, even if it leads to death.
Even if it leads to death. Incluso si eso lo lleva a la muerte. Even if it leads to death.
Decisions, even if it leads to death. But Paul also says God is patient.
God is patient. But Paul also says God is patient.
Dios es paciente.
Pero Pablo también dice, but Paul also says, God is patient.
Sí, Pablo people time que Dios come es to their paciente. Sense.
Giving people time.
Da la gente veces.
God, al pueblo
giving people ver. Time to come to their senses.
Dándole tiempo a la gente.
Uh-huh, to come to their senses.
Para
que regrese.
Para venir.
Para como come to your sense es
como para cobrar sentido
cobra ajá exactamente para que recupera la razón, ¿verdad? Come to your senses, ¿verdad? Estos son los sentidos. Senses son come los sentidos, son los cinco sentidos, ¿verdad?
Come to their
sense. Come to, de recuperar su razón, ¿verdad?
Patient, giving people time to come to their senses and change. Because
and change y cambiar.
Cambien.
God's anger is a response to human evil.
Remember, God's anger is a response to human evil.
Recuerda que la ira de Dios es
una respuesta al mal humano.
A la maldad humana.
Mal de la gente.
A la maldad humana. Evil is maldad.
Because remember, God's anger is a response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character trait, his compassion and his...
Entonces está hablando de su anger,
based on,
¿verdad?,
a deeper character trait.
Sí.
Entonces es based, o sea, su anger, ¿verdad?, su enojo, is based on a deeper character trait.
El carácter deeper.
En profundo, es más profundo. Deeper es más profundo. Rasgo, es trait, miren. Rasgo. Is based on a deeper character trait. Está basado en un rasgo más profundo de su carácter.
And it's based on a deeper character trait, his compassion and
his compassion,
loyal love.
His loyal love. Su compasión, su leal amor.
God is not content to let people sit in their own.
God is not content
in his loyal love. God is not content to let people sit in their
to let people sit. Dios no está contento
in his loyal love. God is not content to let people sit in their own self-destruction.
De que la gente esté sobre sentada, ¿verdad?, sobre su propia autodestrucción.
Content to let people sit in their own self-destruction. In the Bible, God's on a mission to rescue.
In the Bible, God is on a mission to rescue.
Bible, God's on a mission to rescue. This is why Jesus.
This is why Jesus.
Mission to rescue.
Esto es porque
this
Jesús...
is why Jesus said that he was going to Jerusalem to die as a.
That is why Jesus said that he was going to Jerusalem to die.
He was going to Jerusalem.
Por eso Jesús dijo que se iba para Jerusalén a morir.
To Jerusalem to die as a demonstration of God's love for his enemies.
As a demonstration for God, as a demonstration of God's love for his enemies.
A la demostración del amor de Dios por sus enemigos.
He would stand in the place of his people who were choosing self-destruction.
He would stand in the place of his people.
Estaría
en el lugar
él se pararía.
Pueblo.
Él se pararía. He would stand in the place, en el lugar of his people, de su gente. De su gente. Who were, quienes estaban escogiendo, who were choosing, quienes estaban escogiendo autodestrucción, self-destruction.
And take the consequences of their decisions.
And take the consequences of their decisions
on himself.
On himself.
In Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, we see God.
In Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, we see
God's anger at evil.
En Jesús está la vida, la muerte, y la resurrección.
We see God's anger at evil.
En la vida de Jesús, muerte y resurrección, nosotros vemos la ira y la maldad
and his love for people,
y su amor por la gente trabajando juntos para proveer, to provide perdón, forgiveness y vida and life
for a humanity lost,
para una humanidad perdida
paz
en auto de ruina, autodestrucción, ¿verdad? Self-ruin.
Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, we see God's anger at evil and his love for people working together to provide forgiveness and life for a humanity lost in self-ruin. So God's anger in the Bible is really important, but it's not...
So God's anger in the Bible is really important.
Pero Dios en su vida.
No.
La ira de Dios en la Biblia
pero
es real.
La ira de Dios, God's
la
anger
Dios
in the
Biblia
Bible
is
really important.
Importante para
but it is not.
Pero no es.
Pero
Not the end of the story.
The end of the story.
El final.
Pero no es
el final de la historia.
When God is angry and brings justice, because
when God is angry and brings justice,
cuando
Dios está enojado,
y trae justicia,
it's because
porque
he's
extremely patient.
Él es bueno.
And extremely patient.
Extremadamente paciente.
Working out his plan to restore.
En su plan de restaurar.
Restaurar a la gente.
En su amor.
And that's what it means to say that God is slow to anger.
And that is what it means to say that God is slow to anger. Ahora miremoslo todo y ahí vemos si lo entienden.
It could be difficult or daunting. But when the people who wrote the Bible pondered the mystery of God, they consistently describe God's character in this way: compassionate and gracious, slow to anger, overflowing with loyal love and faithfulness. We're going to look at this third phrase, that God is slow to anger. Now, that might surprise some people. Isn't the God of the Bible mostly angry, striking people down for their sins? Well, it turns out that God's anger in the Bible is way more nuanced than that, and way more interesting. In Hebrew, the phrase slow to anger is pronounced erek apayim, or literally long of nose. But what does God's patience have to do with a long nose? Well, first, we need to look at the common biblical Hebrew way to say that someone is angry. Their nose burned hot. Like in the story of Joseph, when Potiphar thinks that Joseph tried to sleep with his wife, his nose burned hot. It's usually translated, his anger burned. It's describing how your body, especially your face, gets hot when you're filled with anger. And so in Hebrew, the main words for anger are either nose or heat or hot nose. This is why a patient person is called long of nose. It takes a long time for their nose to get hot. Like in the biblical proverb, a person's wisdom is their long nose. That is, their slow anger. Now, in the Bible, God gets angry numerous times, but God doesn't have a nose or get hot. These are metaphors, using our experience of hot anger to describe how God feels when he witnesses human evil. Just like you would get angry if you saw a child being bullied on the playground, so God gets angry when humans oppress each other and ruin his world. In the Bible, God's anger is an expression of his justice and his love for the world. But he's slow to anger, which means he gives people lots of time to change. Like in the story of the Exodus, when Pharaoh enslaves the Israelites and has their baby boys thrown into the waters, God sends Moses to confront Pharaoh. And Pharaoh's given 10 chances to let Israel go free, but after the 10th refusal, Pharaoh rides out with his chariots to destroy the Israelites, and so God destroys him in the waters. Pharaoh's own evil is turned back upon him, and we read that this is an act of God's hot anger. Now, that's really intense, but think about it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it. And notice that God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions. And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. Like in the story of the Israelites. Over and over again, for hundreds of years, they betray the God who rescued them from slavery. And though he gives them many chances to turn around, they keep giving their allegiance to the gods of other nations. And each time we read that the hot anger of God burned against the Israelites. But notice what always follows. God gave them over into the hands of their enemies. Israel wanted to serve the gods of other nations, and so God, in his just anger, gives them what they want, as those nations circle back and defeat Israel. This is similar to what the Apostle Paul says in his letter to the Romans. He says, God's anger is being revealed against human evil, and then three times he says what that looks like. God hands people over to their destructive desires and decisions, even if it leads to death. But Paul also says, God is patient, giving people time to come to their senses and change. Because remember, God's anger is a response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character trait, his compassion and his loyal love. God is not content to let people sit in their own self-destruction. In the Bible, God's on a mission to rescue. This is why Jesus said that he was going to Jerusalem to die, as a demonstration of God's love for his enemies. He would stand in the place of his people who were choosing self-destruction and take the consequences of their decisions upon himself. In Jesus' life, death, and resurrection, we see God's anger at evil and his love for people working together to provide forgiveness and life for a humanity lost in self-ruin. So God's anger in the Bible is really important, but it's not the end of the story. When God is angry and brings justice, it's because he's good, and he's extremely patient, working out his plan to restore people to his love. And that's what it means to say that God is slow to anger.
¿Qué tanto entendieron?
Pues después de haber traducido, sí, si no, no.
Sí, sí, sí.
Pero ahora, ahora que ya tradujimos.
Sí, sí. Se entiende un poco más.
Se entiende un poco más.
¿Solo un poco?
No, bastante.
Yo como bastante. Un 80, teacher. Pero porque ya lo tradujimos también.
Solo que hay unas palabras y como que no las termine y no le logro alcanzar a entender.
Sí. Okay. Sin letras, porque las letras obviamente ayudan, ¿verdad?
Nose. What does God's patience have to do with a long nose?
Es que partecitas que se recuerdan muy perfecto, muy exacto, pero hay otras palabras que se me fueron y dijeron, ¿qué era ahí? ¿Qué era ahí? Y ya me perdí.
What does God's patience have to do with a long nose? What does God's patience have to do with a long nose? But what does God's patience have to do with a long nose?
¿Qué dice ahí?
Pero la paciencia
es nariz larga.
Sí, pero ¿qué dice ahí?
What does God's patience have to do with a long nose?
O sea, literalmente, ¿qué dice ahí? En inglés.
¿Cuál es la paciencia de Dios?
What does God's patience have to do?
What does God's patience have to do with a long nose?
¿Qué tiene que ver la paciencia de Dios?
What does God's patience have to do with a long nose?
Exactly.
Well, first, we need to look at the common biblical Hebrew way to say that someone is angry.
¿Ahí qué dijo?
Cool Hebrew way to say
that. Vamos a ver el...
Well, first, we need to look at the common biblical Hebrew way to say that someone is angry.
¿Ahí qué fue lo que dijo?
Pero lo primero que tenemos que ver es acerca de lo que algo de Hebreos dice acerca de.
To say that someone is angry.
Es de la forma hebrea de decir cuando alguien está enojado, ¿verdad?
The common biblical Hebrew way to say that.
The common biblical Hebrew way. The common biblical Hebrew way. La manera hebrea bíblica común.
¿No? Common biblical Hebrew way to. Well, first we need to look at the common biblical Hebrew way to say that someone is angry.
To say that someone is angry. ¿Verdad?
Their nose burned hot.
Vamos
like
a ver
in this
otro lugar.
Get hot. These are metaphors, using our experience of hot anger to describe how God feels when he witnesses human evil.
¿Qué dice ahí?
Describe how God feels when he witnesses human evil.
Literalmente, ¿qué dice? En
¿cómo
inglés.
How God when feels...
He witnesses human
witness.
Evil.
When he witnesses human evil.
Evil.
How God feels when he witnesses human evil. Just like you would get angry if you saw a child being bullied on the playground.
Vamos a ver en otro lugar.
Of God's hot anger. Now, that's really intense. But think about it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh.
Es que realmente intenso.
Aquí vamos a ver esta parte aquí.
God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually...
¿Qué dice ahí?
angry at Pharaoh's evil and allow it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually.
God wouldn't be good. ¿Verdad?
He didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil. Think about it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually.
God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil.
Good if he didn't get angry. It's really intense. But think about it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something
about it. Entienden.
God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and
o sea, God wouldn't be good. Dios no sería bueno. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil. Dios no sería bueno si él no se enojara a la maldad de Faraón.
About it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it.
Después, ¿qué dice?
No, pobrecita, aquí se nos los bomberos.
Ah, de que no la querían dejar ir.
¿Qué pasó?
¿Y ahora?
¿Qué entra en la tierra?
¿Eh? Bueno, pues sí. ¿Qué dice después?
But think about it. God wouldn't be good if he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it.
¿Qué dice después? God's evil?
Angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it.
¿Qué dice ahí?
Y eventualmente a pensar acerca de eso.
And eventually do something about it.
Y eventualmente hacer algo acerca de eso.
Ajá.
If he didn't get angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it. And notice that God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions.
¿Qué dijo ahí? En español.
Do something about it. And notice that God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions.
¿Qué dice ahí?
Solo lo último se me quedó, teacher. Que esas eran las consecuencias por hacer eso.
Por tomar mi propia decisión.
Angry at Pharaoh's evil and eventually do something about it. And notice that God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions.
And notice that God's anger is expressed.
¿Notó?
And notice that God's anger is anger is expressed. By handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions.
Entregando.
Pharaoh to the consequences of his own decisions.
Faraón, las consecuencias
acerca de por sus decisiones.
O sea, y nota que la ira de Dios es expresada al entregar a Faraón a las consecuencias de sus propias decisiones.
God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions. And notice that God's anger is expressed by handing Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions. And this is.
¿Sí lo logran comprender?
Uh-huh.
¿Sí? ¿Sí?
It's actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. Like.
¿Y aquí?
His own decisions. And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. Like.
¿Qué dice ahí?
How God's anger is shown throughout the Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions. Pharaoh over to the consequences of his own decisions. And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. Actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures. Like in the story. And this is actually.
Es como se muestra la ira de Dios en las escrituras, algo así.
This is actually.
Esto es realmente.
Of his own decisions.
Lo que muestra.
And this is actually. Y esto realmente es. And this is actually.
And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures.
And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures.
Es mostrado a través de las escrituras.
Entonces esto es realmente como la ira de Dios es mostrada, is shown throughout the scriptures.
Decisions. And this is actually how God's anger is shown throughout the scriptures, like in the story of the Israelites.
Vamos a escuchar en otra parte.
What they want, as those nations circle back and defeat decisions, even if it leads to death. But Paul also says God is patient, giving people time to come to their senses and change.
¿Qué dice ahí?
Dios es paciente dándoles tiempo para que cambien su sentido.
Para, ¿cómo se decía? Recuperar su razón, ¿verdad?
Recobrar sus sentidos.
Recobrar sus sentidos, ¿verdad? To come to their senses, ¿verdad? Recuperar sus sentidos, recuperar la razón.
God is patient, giving people time to come to their senses and change. Because remember, God's anger is a response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character change. Because remember, God's anger is a response to human evil.
Porque recuerden que la ira de Dios es una respuesta.
To human evil.
A la maldad humana.
De la maldad.
No change. Because remember, God's anger is a response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character trait, his compassion.
And it's based on a deeper character trait.
God's anger is a response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character trait, his compassion and his loyal love. God is not.
¿Qué dice?
Passion and his response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character trait, his compassion and his loyal love.
¿Qué dijo ahí?
Es ahí donde no entiendo.
Pues una base como profunda sobre.
Dice. Remember, dice, mira. Pues.
Is a response to human evil, and it's based on a deeper character trait.
And it's based on a deeper character trait. ¿Qué dijimos que era trait? Rasgo. And it's based on a deeper character trait. ¿Qué significa? Ya se va a cortar.
Se me olvidó.
Está basado en un rasgo más profundo de su carácter.
His compassion and his loyal love. God is not content to let people sit in their own self-destruction.
Chicos, les queda un minuto. Espero que les haya servido.
Gracias.
Que Dios los bendiga. Que tengan un lindo día. Cuídense mucho.
Bendiciones.
La primera parte no se grabó, solo la segunda parte. La primera parte dio error. Así que voy a subir esta segunda parte. Que tengan un lindo día. ¿Sí?
Bueno, chao a todos.
Bendiciones. Por su tiempo. Bendiciones.
Por millones. Gracias a usted, teacher.
Gracias por todo su apoyo en los laboratorios. Que Dios los bendiga.
Gracias, teacher. Dios me lo bendiga bastante. Gracias por su tiempo.
Saludcita para todos.
Bendiciones. Bye, bye.
Gracias, adiós.
Bye.
Adiós.